en question. On ជំរុញជំរះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចចំណាការនីតិវិធីសម្រាប់ការសម្រាប់ការនៅថ្ងៃនេះអង្គជំរះបន្តធ្វើសម្រាប់ការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មសក្ខីខំបឿនតាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍ឡាមជីសម្រាប់ការលោកអែមហួយនៅរីកាពិចារណាភាពវត្តមានអវត្តមានភាគីនិងបុគ្គលដែលអង្គជំរះឬក៏អញ្ជើញឲ្យចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចចំណាការសម្រាប់ការថ្ងៃនេះ
សម្រាប់លោកធានសម្រាប់សវនកម្មថ្ងៃនេះកាលាមជីក៏សម្គាល់ឃើញថាគ្រប់ភាគីទាំងអស់នៃរឿងក្តីមានវត្តមានឥឡូវលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រមសាលសវនកម្មនេះដោយលោកស្នើសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធិមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទប់សវនកម្មលិខិតលះបង់សិទ្ធិរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាបានប្រគល់ដល់កាលាមជីរួចហើយ សាក់សីដែលត្រូវមកផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មបញ្ចប់នៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺលោកស្រីខំបឿនតាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍ពីខេត្តបាត់ដំបងតាមការបញ្ជាក់ពីផ្នែកបច្ចេកទេសសោទស្សន៍បានជួលដំណឹងថាការរៀបចំផ្នែកបច្ចេកទេសសម្រាប់ការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មនោះពេលនេះបានរៀបចំរួចរាល់ហើយរីឯសាក់សីនិងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាលោកមុំរធាបាន
ត្រៀមខ្លួនរួចជាស្រេចសម្រាប់ការផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មនេះសូមអរគុណលោកធានបាទអរគុណជាបឋមនេះអង្គជំរះសម្រេចលើសម្រាប់សុំរបស់នួនជាជាមុនសិនអង្គជំរះបានទទួលលិខិតសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមសកម្មភាពការដៃផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនេះរបស់ជួនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចុះថ្ងៃទី 5 ខែឧសភាឆ្នាំ2015ដែលបានបញ្ជាក់ថាដោយគាត់មានបញ្ហាសុខភាពឈឺក្បាលឈឺចង្កេះមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបាននិងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនេះថ្ងៃខាងមុខឲ្យមានប្រសិទ្ធភាព ខ្លួនសូមលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមនឹងមានវត្តមានដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃទី 5 ខែឧសភាឆ្នាំ 2015 មេធាវីការពារក្តីរបស់ខ្លួនបានប្រាប់អំពីផលប៉ះពាល់នៃការលះបង់សិទ្ធនេះថាការលះបង់សិទ្ធនេះមិនអាចបកស្រាយថាជាការលះបង់សិទ្ធរបស់ខ្លួនក្នុងការកាត់សេចក្តីដែលយុត្តិធម៌ឬក៏សិទ្ធក្នុងការទៅជំទាស់ទៅនឹងភស្តុតាងក្នុងការដាក់បង្ហាញឬដាក់ជូនតុលាការនេះគ្រប់ពេលវេលានៃសកម្មភាពឬខ្លួនឡើយ បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុវិនិច្ឆ័យសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្យប្រចាំការពិនិត្យភិបាលថែទាំសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនៅអវតកចុះថ្ងៃទី 5 ខែឧសភាឆ្នាំ 2015បានកត់សម្គាល់ថាស្ថានភាពសុខភាពរបស់នួនជាមានជំងឺឆ្អឹងចង្កេះនិងបានផ្ដល់អនុសាសន៍ថាសូមអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកនួនជាចូលរួមនឹងតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីបន្ទប់ខាងក្រោមសាលសកម្មភាពនេះ ឯលើមូលដ្ឋាននេះនឹងយោងតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធាន 661នៃវិធានផ្ទៃក្នុងអវតកអង្គជំរះយល់ព្រមនឹងអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាបន្តចូលរួមនឹងតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្រោមសាលសកម្មភាពនេះក្នុងរយៈពេលនៃកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះបាទមុននឹងប្រាប់វិទ្យាជូនទៅភិក្ខុមេធាវីការពីក្រីអង្គស្វាទៅអរលោកលោកស្រីចក្រមតាមមានទំនួរអ្វីចង់ស្វាទៅសាក់សីខ
Chàng xong dùm riêng Lô Phật Thiên Cả tay anh tăng khá nhầm mình chăm Bê về lìa nâng ngày khai tế tế nhầm chăm khá nông chân nằm Cứ trong chân nằm chạy sập bày Ai cả tay anh tăng mình miền chìa cam bị thi ấy tế cứ còn tập rạp Ai thua Tại bằng nọ
Et est-ce que vous vous souvenez du nom de vos prédécesseurs, des personnes qui, avant vous, étaient à la tête de cette commune? Est-ce que le nom Est-ce que le nom de Sao Van, alias Sao Port, vous dit quelque chose? Alors, je vous prie de m'excuser parce que mon accent, évidemment, est très mauvais, mais le nom que je veux porter à votre connaissance est celui de Sao Van, alias Sao Port. Quelles étaient les responsabilités de cette personne? Il était responsable en même temps que vous? Et jusqu'à quand?
Dans votre audition, vous avez parlé de quelqu'un qui s'appelle Sam Bit. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous dire quel était le rôle de Sam
Bit?
Avez-vous assisté à des réunions présidées par Sam Bit? Et si oui, quels étaient les sujets qui ont été discutés pendant ces réunions? Hier, on vous a parlé également d'une personne qui s'appelait Dam et qui travaillait au bureau du district.
Vous avez dit que vous vous souveniez de cette personne. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous préciser quel était exactement son rôle au bureau du district? Quelles étaient alors ses fonctions? S'il ne travaillait pas au bureau du district, qu'est-ce qu'il faisait? Avez-vous eu l'occasion de discuter avec Dan? Est-ce que vous l'avez rencontré?
Oui, excusez-moi pour cette interruption, bonjour. Je crois qu'il y a effectivement une petite confusion concernant la prononciation, puisqu'on a parlé de dame, et puis je crois que la personne que le juge voulait viser au bureau du district, c'était plutôt Dorn, T-A, accent circonflexe N, donc je ne sais pas si on peut clarifier les noms qui ont été mentionnés,
Madame le témoin, est-ce que vous avez entendu le procureur? Il semble qu'il y ait peut-être deux personnes, dame qui travaillait à Krang Tan Chan et Dorn qui travaillait au bureau du district. Est-ce que vous vous souvenez de Dorn qui travaillait au bureau du district? Et jusqu'à quand Dorn a-t-il travaillé au bureau du district? Où est-il allé après? Alors, maintenant, on va parler de Dam, celui qui travaillait à Krang Tan Chan. Est-ce qu'il a travaillé tout le temps à Krang Tan Chan? Ou est-ce qu'à un moment, il a cessé ses fonctions à Krang Tan Chan? Avez-vous su si Dam avait par la suite été lui-même détenu à Krang Tan Chan? Est-ce que vous vous souvenez que l'on vous a montré un document?
C'est
le document D157.64. Est-ce que le conseil qui est à côté de vous pourrait vous montrer ce document? Avez-vous trouvé ce document?
D157.64.
Alors, pour le transcript, je précise que l'ERN en Khmer est le suivant, 00 27 09 74 à 75. L'ERN en français est 00 78 92 72, l'ERN en 73, et l'ERN en anglais est 00 36 36 55 55. Voilà. Madame le témoin, avez-vous pu voir ce document? Est-ce que ce document vous rappelle quelque chose?
ກະຕິນາເຈຄົນຈະລົມເມືອງໃຫ້ມັນຄືນຈາກຍົ້ມເຄີຍ
Est-ce que vous voyez la signature au bas de ce document? Est-ce que vous reconnaissez cette signature?
ចាហត្ថលេខាគឺឈ្មោះខ្ញុំតែខ្ញុំនឹកមិនឃើញ
Alors, il y a également une mention à côté de votre signature où il est dit ceci. Copié à partir du camarade Huot du comité de l'unité 4. Est-ce que vous savez qui est Huot du comité de l'unité 4? Qui était Huo? Quelle était la fonction de cette unité? C'était une unité de la milice. Quel était le travail de l'unité? Alors, est-ce que vous pouvez expliquer pourquoi on a marqué copié à partir du camarade Huo? Quel était le rôle de Huo dans cette affaire? Alors, je peux vous dire ce que je lis dans la version que j'ai entre les mains, qui est une version française, et il est marqué à la fin, fait à Changtong le 21 juillet 1977. Je précise que par ailleurs, nous avons un autre document, qui est le document E3/4164, ERN en français 00-93-71-04 et 00-97-31-47 en en anglais et en khmer 00079 337 à 338. Ce document s'intitule « Biographie succincte des prisonniers du bureau éducatif du district de Tramkhak » et le premier nom qui figure sur cette liste est celui de Nieng Dam, qui est appelé Cheng Dam en anglais, et il est indiqué que la date d'entrée en rééducation et le 20 juillet 1977. Alors, est-ce que cela vous rafraîchit la mémoire?
ហើយក៏តាក់តងជាមួយនឹងនាងខ្ញុំនៅឆ្នាំ77 ខ្ញុំនៅក្នុងធ្វើការងារនៅក្នុងឃុំនៅឡើយឯក្របខណ្ឌគាត់នៅក្រាំងតាចាន់គឺជាក្របខណ្ឌបាត់ស្រុកចាំបានខ្ញុំមិនយល់ហើយក៏ខ្ញុំអត់នឹកឃើញ
Madame le témoin, j'ai peur que vous ne... J'ai peur qu'il y ait une erreur. Mais quand j'ai donné lecture du document sur lequel le nom de Nieng Dam figurait, c'était en tant que prisonnier, pas en tant que membre du personnel de Krangtanchan. Il a, et nous l'avons entendu, été membre du personnel de Krangtanchan, mais il semble que par la suite, il ait été prisonnier. Alors, je vous précise aussi que nous venons de vous donner connaissance d'un rapport qui porte votre signature et qui date de la même période, et la période à laquelle il a, semble-t-il, été arrêté et conduit à Krangtanchan. Avez-vous des explications?
តើលោកស្រីអាចបញ្យល់បានទេត្រង់ចំណុចនេះចាព្រោះដាំមិនមែននៅក្នុងឃុំជាងតងទេតែខ្ញុំស្គាល់តែមិនមែននៅក្នុងឃុំជាងតងទេគាត់នៅឃុំតាពាំងធំខាងជើងហេតុអីបានជាមកតាក់តងខ្ញុំហើយខ្ញុំមិនយល់
Bien, écoutez, on va passer à autre chose. Madame le témoin, lorsque vous avez été entendue parler au juge d'instruction, vous avez dit que il vous arrivait parfois de ne pas toujours respecter les consignes que vous receviez de l'échelon supérieur. Et vous avez dit en particulier qu'il vous était arrivé de cacher du riz. Est-ce que vous pouvez le confirmer?
ផែនការមានមែនពីលើតែផែនការខ្លះឧទាហរណ៍ជាក់ស្ដែងដូចជាការហូបចុកបោះវិជាជនខ្វះខាតហើយពេលដែលធ្វើស្រោមក៏បានខ្ញុំអាចធ្វើបញ្ជីបញ្ជូនអត់អស់លាក់ទុកខ្លះដើម្បីផ្គត់ផ្គង់នៅក្នុងឃុំឲ្យវិជាជនបានហូបគ្រប់គ្រាន់នេះជាការពិត
Avez-vous caché du riz en infraction aux consignes qui vous étaient données par le district?
Oui,
Combien de fois est-ce que vous avez caché Assiduri et pour quelle raison? Est-ce qu'il vous arrivait de voir ou de constater que des gens mouraient parce qu'ils n'avaient pas assez à manger? Je vous demande pas de faire des suppositions, madame. Je vous demande de me dire ce que vous savez. Est-ce que cela s'est produit ou est-ce que cela ne s'est pas produit? Est-ce qu'il y a eu des pénuries alimentaires et est-ce que des gens en sont morts? Je ne comprends pas votre réponse, madame, parce que juste avant de nous dire que il y avait sans doute eu des morts dues à une sous-alimentation, que les gens avaient été malades. Alors, où est-ce que les gens étaient malades? Partout ailleurs, sauf dans votre commune? Et c'était la même situation ailleurs dans le district? Ou est-ce que la situation était pire ou meilleure ailleurs? Vous n'avez jamais discuté des problèmes de production au niveau, lorsque vous aviez des réunions au niveau du district, madame? Jamais ces problèmes-là n'ont été évoqués.
មិនដែលមានការលើកឡើងអំពីបញ្ហាហ្នឹងទេមែនទេចាប្រជុំនៅថ្នាក់ស្រុកមានលើកតែលើកពីការបង្កើនផលធ្វើស្រែវស្សាដាំដំណាំរួមផ្សំនិងធ្វើស្រែប្រាំងដើម្បីរក bien à ham, hop, croup.
Bien, j'aurais une dernière question, madame. Vous avez été entendu également par le bureau des co-juges d'instruction et vous avez été entendu par rapport à une annotation qui figure sur un document où est mentionné le mot Comptik en Khmer. Comptik, écrasé. Alors, lorsque ce mot s'applique à des personnes arrêtées, détenues ou considérées comme ennemies, quel est le sens du mot Comptik? Alors, que veut dire nettoyage selon vous, madame? Madame, quelqu'un qui était envoyé à Kreng Tan Shan et pour lequel on disait, on donnait l'ordre de l'écraser. À votre avis, quel pouvait être le sens de cet ordre? Madame, et ça sera ma dernière observation, je vous rappellerai votre réponse qui figure dans le document E319-12-3-2, réponse 264, le terme smash, mint, kill. Vous vous rappelez avoir dit ça, madame? Bien, si vous n'avez pas d'autres commentaires, je n'aurai pas d'autres questions à vous poser, madame. Merci, M. le Président. Juste pour confirmer, vous avez bien dit cela aux couches d'instruction. Ils n'ont pas inventé. Ce que je viens de lire à la réponse 264, madame, c'est bien vous qui l'avez dit, ou est-ce que ce sont les enquêteurs qui l'ont inventé?
Je suis allé à la maison.
Qui vous l'avait dit? Et qui était Prak?
Prak nang chi neak na dae?
Prak nang chi thnak dambon.
Merci madame, je n'aurai pas d'autres questions à vous poser.
Som okon lok srei khnyom os samnu hai. Okon lok pathean.
Ba, okon lok krom. Ba lai ni om meh pral vidika chun teu krom mitvika phiek dai dai tambong ni pdol teu krom mitvika phiek dai lok nun chi dambei men okas tang thnmot dai dal chpo sak sai khom buen. Som cheung ba.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. Good morning, Madam Witness. My name is Victor Koppe. I am the international co-lawyer for Nguyen Chia, and I have some questions to ask to you. First, I would like to start with some follow-up questions to questions from the judge this morning. You said that at some occasions you were hiding rice to feed your people. When you say, quote unquote, my people, what exactly do you mean with that?
And when you talk about my people, does it also include the people who had arrived from Phnom Penh or from Takio provincial town and who were considered new people? So in supplying food to the people of your commune, you made no distinction at all between new people and old people, is that correct? How about access to hospitals for people who were sick? And access to medicine for people who are sick. Did you in your commune make any distinction between new people and old people in terms of access to hospitals and medicines?
And how about education? Was there a difference in treatment for children of parents coming from Phnom Penh or the old people? In other words, did everybody in your commune have access to education?
Summarizing, Madam Witness, would it be fair to say that in your commune you did not discriminate so-called new people? In your commune, did you ever send somebody for re-education simply because he was a new person? Or if you send somebody for re-education, that person had to be had to have done something wrong?
ខ្ញុំអត់មានបានបញ្ជូនដោយខ្លួនឯងទេមានធ្វើខុសគឺរាយការណ៍ជូនណាក់លើហើយមានបញ្ជាពីលើបានបញ្ជូនចា
I understand, but are you aware of situations in your commune or maybe other communes within District 105 in which people were punished simply because they were new
people?
Thank you, Madam Witness. Some two more short questions on the food situation. I would like to read to you a question and answer that you gave to the investigators of the International Co-Investigating Judge. That's document E319/12.3.2. It is your answer to question 56. The subject is Tamok, and whether you know Tamok. And the question is, did you personally know him? And you answer to the investigators as follows. Yes, I personally knew him. Sometimes he came to see the cooperative kitchen and he asked the people whether they ate enough or not. Tamok visited every site. I met Tamok. Can you be, it's a long time ago, I realize, but can you be a little more specific as to what exactly Tamok asked you or asked the people whether they ate enough, yes or no? Was he, in other words, was he concerned about the food situation of the people in the district?
គាត់បានចុះផ្ទាល់ប្រគាត់តែចុះដល់ភូមិដល់សហគមន៍ហ្មងទៅសួរប្រជាជនផ្ទាល់មិនមែនសួរខ្ញុំទេ
Was it your understanding that he was concerned about the situation of food for the people?
យល់ថាគាត់ព្រួយបារម្ភឬក៏គាត់គិតអំពីបញ្ហាស្បៀងអាហាររបស់ប្រជាជនចឹងមែនទេចាគាត់ព្រួយបារម្ភតាមមើលគាត់ព្រួយបារម្ភដែរ
Did you ever witness any action on his side when he saw or concluded that the food situation was difficult?
đòi khuyên quạt do bị cái lạnh xem xem tập quật cùng cái lạnh khoa
In your recollection, Madam Witness, was it the goal of the regime to make sure that everybody in democratic Cambodia had enough to eat?
កន្លែងដែលខ្ញុំរស់នៅទេកន្លែងផ្សេងទៀតតែខ្ញុំក្តាប់អត់បានដែរ
So within your area, was it the objective of
the regime
that everybody
in
the place where you were assigned to had enough to eat? And if that was the case, was it the instructions of the upper echelon to fix the situation as soon as possible?
អបរំពីលើឲ្យខំដោះស្រាយជីវភាពឲ្យប្រជាជន
yesterday madam witness you were asked about the stealing of food by people who were hungryAnd you said, I believe, that that was considered to be a minor offense. If someone had committed such a minor offense, for instance, stealing a coconut because the person was hungry, what would be the sanction against this person? What would happen to this person? Somebody who just stole a coconut because he or she was hungry. What would happen to that person?
Cha, cha, ao mien ao mien ca da ton cam away da rite.
Cha, ao mien te mien ta ao prom prap ngai kroy tro ot ot nang ot khnie mien mien nang ot khnie cha.
Are you aware of any example either within your commune or in other communes within District 105 people who were executed because they stole
a
coconut or a cassave? Were you implementing the party line when it comes to sanctioning people who had stolen food because they were
hungry?
ខ្ញុំអត់មានតែបានអប់រំឲ្យដាក់ទណ្ឌកម្មឲ្យអ្នកដែលលួចជាដងជាដំឡូងហើយថាលួចពីការស្រីឃ្លាននេះគឺអត់ដែលមានធ្វើទណ្ឌកម្មទេចា៎មានតែអប់រំបើយើងឃ្លានឃ្លានទាំងអស់គ្នាអត់ទាំងអស់គ្នាក្រោយក្រោយកុំធ្វើចឹងទៀតតែប៉ុណ្ណឹង
And And in such situations that you didn't sanction somebody, were you following the instructions from the upper echelon?
តាមការណែនាំពីលើថាបើការលួចហូបចុកខ្វះខាតគឺមិនត្រូវធ្វើតែរន្តកម្មឬដាក់ទណ្ឌកម្មឲ្យដល់ប្រជាជនដូច្នេះខ្ញុំអនុវត្តតាមនឹងធ្វើតាមនឹង
And did you implement that instruction regardless whether the person was a new person or an old person? One very last question on the food situation, Madam Witness. Are you aware of any instances in which a person who was of the Cham origin was forced to eat pork against her or his will? Thank you, Madam Witness. I would like to turn to another subject on which you have been asked already some questions, and that is the policy about marriage within your commune and district. I would like to read a few excerpts from your earlier statement, and I will put them together, and then I would like to ask your comment on this. First, I would like to start with your answer to question 111, A111. The commune level. Let me ask the question first. Let me cite the question first. During the Khmer Rouge regime, the party arranged marriages. How did they arrange the marriages? Was there a discussion within the sector level, or was that decided by the cooperative level or village level? The second part of your answer, because the first part was read yesterday, the second part of your answer is, the ones who loved each other came to inform us, and we listed their names and sent their names to the sector. Those who did not agree also told us they did not agree, and we crossed out their names. In answer 112, you said, if the new people had to marry the old people, and if anyone refused, we could cross their names out because some people had bad backgrounds. 114, at my site, I checked which men and women worked together and got along with each other, so I arranged them to marry one another. And finally, your answer in 116. What happened? The question is, what happened if they refused to get married as arranged? Your answer, nothing like that happened at my site. They all had known one another because my site was not large. We arranged their marriage and the couples agreed. But if the upper level did not approve, they could not marry. Now, Madam Witness, having read these four excerpts from your statement, is it fair to conclude that in your commune there were no examples of people forcibly married to each other?
ប្រជាជនត្រូវបានគេបង្ខំឲ្យរៀបការទេតើអញ្ចឹងមែនទេ
to be clear, if anybody, any man or any woman did not want to marry another woman or man, then this person could tell so. Is that correct? And then the person wouldn't have to marry. One last question in respect of marriage policy. Yesterday you spoke about people who divorced after their marriage. Were you speaking about divorces in the time that you were commune chief? Or were you speaking about divorces after 1979?
จ้ะខ្ញុំចង់បាននិយាយថាការរៀបការដែលរៀបគូស្ម័គ្រចិត្តហើយហ្នឹងក៏អាចខ្លះមានលែងលះគ្នាក៏មានហើយប្រជាជនចាស់ហ្នឹងក៏មានអញ្ចឹងដូចគ្នាដែរធម្មតាហ្នឹង
But just to be clear, are you speaking about divorce within the period between 1975 and 1979? Were people allowed to divorce during the regime of Democratic Kampuchea within your commune?
ការរៀបចំឲ្យនឹងមានលះលែងគ្នាទាំងប្រជាជនចាស់ទាំងប្រជាជនថ្មីមានដូចគ្នាតែខ្ញុំមិនបានជាដឹងជាចំនួនទេប៉ុន្តែមានចាឆ្លោះតោះតែងគ្នាហើយក៏គ្មានធ្វើទេរនកម្មឯដែរនៃការស្ម័គ្រចិត្ត
It's a long time ago, Madam Witness, I realize that, but do you remember any couples from your commune who got divorced between 75 and 79?
Chạm miền, tại nhà mình chạm chắc bà, tì cả lai như rưu gò, bê về lìa tì. Tại miền để nhầm chấm điệp hạng đào mà chẳng miền.
Did they get divorced when you were still commune chief?
Ta puk ke leng leh na pe da luk srei thveu chi me khum nung men te.
Cha.
Did you as commune chief have to give permission for the divorce of these couples?
ទៅពេលដែលប្តីប្រពន្ធនឹងចង់លេងលះគ្នាដល់ទីស្កុបចាទៅມັນអនុញ្ញាតក៏គេលេងដូច្នេះខ្ញុំអត់មានបញ្ហាទំនាស់ទេគ្រាន់ថាអប់រំឲ្យយកគ្នាវិញស្រស់ស្រួលគ្នាវិញហើយគេថាយកគ្នាមិនបានអាហ្នឹងក៏
Thank you, Madam Witness. Now I would like to move to another subject. Subject of district chief called Kom in answer 285 of your interview before the investigators of the co-investigating judge, you said that Khom had mental problems. Could you describe a little bit more what you remember from the personality of Khom?
ចាខំជាមនុស្សតែគាត់មិនដូចយើងគ្រប់គ្នាគាត់មានរបៀបថាថាតែសាយប្រសាទឬក៏ពាក្យគេថាឆ្កួតប៉ុន្តែមិនជាប់ពេលខ្លះឆ្កួតពេលខ្លះជា
And do you know what kind of psychiatric problem Khom had?
Khom mean panha khuok ba nung panha avay dae.
Khom at ban dang dae kon khuen. Chang.
I understand that the title of her disease is maybe difficult to describe, but could you, if you remember, describe her behavior? What was it that made you say, as many others, that she had mental problems? What was her behavior like?
Nhóm mình sau bàn nấu đặt đo đấy để cho người ta riêng rõ bọc nhóm có việc bàn vật vật cọt tại nhóm khuyên cọt chặt cho ra cọt đi năng khuyên tập bằng năng ai nhà cặp kê giá cọt.
Maybe I understand it's not very nice to speak about someone's mental problems, but if you try to remember, what was it that Khom did which indicated that she had psychiatric problems?
Nhóm có bà riêng rộp đấy, bạn trong phương phê khá là gọt đau đạch bái đạch tức cả miền. Hãy nhóm một bàn rôn đôi chết đặt đấy, khơi mà đo mà càn. Mình ai rộp riêng bàn thì...
My final question on Khom, Madam Witness, do you remember whether her mental illness influenced the decisions that she made within the district?
จ้าบารมได้គាត់สำเร็จการงานในក្នុងภูมิស្រុកអីគឺគាត់มันសូវបានវិភាសាគាត់ច្រើនអត្តនោម័តដែរខ្ញុំដឹងបានតែប៉ុណ្្នឹងឯងចា
I understand, but my question was whether you know if her mental illness in some way influenced the decisions that she made.
ផ្លេចបាត់ទៅយូរពេកហើយ
Mr. President, I am looking at the clock. This could be a moment to have a break.
បាទអរគុណលោកស្រីខំបឿនហើយនឹងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយយើងសម្រាប់ចាប់ពីពេលនេះតទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10កន្លះសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពសូមលោកស្រីខំបឿនហើយជាមួយនឹងរួមទាំងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាមានវត្តមាននៅកន្លែងផ្ដល់សេចក្ដីកម្មនៅវេលាម៉ោង10និង30នាទីសម្រាប់ចុះមក10នាទីតើជឿយកវិញបាទ
អត់តែខ្ញុំឈរខ្លួនខ្ញុំបានទុកបាទ